Hello, my friends. This video here has been a long time coming, and we're finally diving into how to get Articulate Storyline up and running on one of the new Macs with the M1 chip. So as you may know, Apple released a new line of computers this year in 2021, and they have this M1 processor. So this is Apple's like proprietary processor, and it is very, very good. Rave reviews across the board. I think it surpassed everyone's expectations. Great battery life, great performance. It makes your machine feel very, very zippy and fast. But as instructional designers and e-learning developers, the big question for us has been, well, can we use Articulate Storyline on it? Because as you also probably know, Storyline is a Windows-only application. And since this M1 chip uses a different architecture, the answer for a long time was just, no, you can't use Storyline on these machines, and it was looking pretty grim for a while here. Traditionally, on a Mac, you can use a program called Bootcamp to get Windows up and running on your computer, but that's just not available on the Macs with the M1 chip right now. So fortunately, Parallels came out with an update that does let you run Windows on these M1 devices. So in this video, I'll be using the base version of an M1 MacBook Air, but this should be pretty similar for MacBook Pros or the Mac Minis or any other Mac device with the M1 chip, because going forward, Apple is probably only going to be using these chips. So like I said, this has been a long time coming. I've had this MacBook ever since it was released, basically. I just haven't been doing Storyline development on it since I have this desktop PC. But the past week, I got Storyline up and running on it. I put it to the test. I tried to put some pretty demanding loads on Storyline. And if you want the short answer and you don't want to see this entire video about how to get it up and running and then seeing some actual clips so you can see where it gets a little laggy and where it does well, the short answer is that these machines can handle Storyline development tasks just fine. You will be making some compromises going with a Mac instead of a Windows, but the compromises you make with Storyline development, you gain just with like this thing working and feeling great right out of the box for just about everything else besides Storyline. So we're going to dive into it. Again, I'm going to show you exactly how to get Storyline up and running on a Mac with an M1 chip, and then we'll do kind of a performance review and see what development actually looks like so that you can make a choice about whether a Mac will be good for you with your professional instructional design and e-learning development goals. So let's dive right into it. So to run Windows on a Mac with an M1 chip, we need to join the Windows Insider program so that we can download a special version of Windows. So to do that, we need to go to insider.windows.com, and then we'll scroll down a bit, select the blue register button, and then we need to either sign into an existing Microsoft account or create a new one. After signing in, you'll need to go ahead and accept the terms of the Windows Insider Program agreement, and then we are good to go. From there, we need to download Parallels. So I'm going to parallels.com, then we'll select Download Free Trial for Parallels Desktop 16, and we'll continue to follow the prompts to go ahead and download Parallels to our computer. After that file is done downloading, go ahead and open it up from the Downloads folder. From there, we will double-click the Install Parallels Desktop icon, we'll confirm that we want to open it, and we will give Parallels access to the Downloads folder. Accept the software agreement and give Parallels all of the permissions that it asks for so that it can function as we need it to. Okay, we are making progress. This is where things will change if you're on a Mac with an M1 chip. Parallels will tell you we need a special version of Windows, and they have a really helpful article that walks you through exactly what to do. In that article, we will find a link that goes directly to the Microsoft page, and that is where we'll find the download we need to get Parallels up and running with Windows. It tells us we need to sign into our Microsoft account, so we'll select the profile icon in the top right, and then we'll go ahead and sign in to the account that we used earlier to join the Windows Insider program. Okay, this is what we needed. Now the Windows 10 Insider Preview build is available to us, so we can go ahead and click on it and download it to our Mac. Hop back over to Parallels once that file is done downloading, and then follow the prompts on the screen to go ahead and select that file that we just downloaded. Keep pressing continue until we get to the point where it's creating your Windows 10 instance. This will take a few minutes, but once it's done, go ahead and create your Parallels account. Now accept the terms of service and wait for Windows 10 to load. I know that we've been moving quickly, but as you can see, we do have Windows 10 running on a Mac with an M1 chip now. So all that's left to do is to go ahead and download Storyline. So we need to go to 360.articulate.com and then select sign in the top right. You can sign in with your Articulate account, then select Storyline 360, and after that, select the blue Start Download button. Once it's done downloading, open up the file and select Install Now. Select Yes, select Finish, and then wait for the sign-in window to appear. Open the window with Microsoft Edge, and then wait for the browser to authenticate you. Select one of the launch buttons, and then select Install right next to Storyline 360. Once Storyline is done installing, we need to do something that we probably should have done earlier. We will go to the Actions tab in our taskbar at the top, we'll hover over that, and then we will select Shut Down. Once the virtual machine is shut down, we need to select the settings wheel in the top right, and now we can change the number of processors that we're using to 4 and the amount of memory that we're using to 4096 megabytes. This will give our Windows virtual machine more processing power so that Storyline can run better than it would have with the default settings. Now we'll select the play button to start Windows 10 right back up, and then we can select continue trial. Now select the Articulate 360 shortcut from the desktop, and then select open next to Storyline 360. So for me, Storyline kind of just froze here for a while until eventually I got a notification saying that Parallels desktop needed access to the Mac's accessibility features. So I gave it the permissions it needed on the Mac side of things, and then I just went ahead and tried to reopen Storyline on the Windows side of things, and it opened without any problems the second time around. Select new project when it opens, and now we are officially in. We are in Storyline on a Mac with an M1 chip, so it's time to play around. So this is in real time now, just so you can get a feel for what it's like to add images, add some text, move those images around and resize them. You can see the program is quite responsive for basic tasks like this. Next up, I made a slide where I added characters from Storyline's content library, and it honestly was going really smoothly. There were some parts where there is a little tiny bit of lag. For example, look at when I try to change the character out with a different character. So there was quite a bit of lag when it came to making changes to characters that were already on the screen, but overall, I'd say that it is a manageable experience. The other big sticking point is when it comes to editing states. So I edited the state for each one of the characters on these screens to change their pose and their expression, and this is probably where I saw some of the worst lag in all of the testing that I did. So check this out and see whether or not this would be manageable for you. There is quite a bit of lag also when I try to create a new trigger for the first time, and as you'll see later in the video, there is a bit of a workaround for this. So you'll notice when my mouse goes over these words, I'm actually clicking on them, but it takes a second or two for it to actually register. I was able to build out the states and these triggers in just about 90 seconds or so, and the slide previewed just fine. You can see it takes a little bit of time to load up the preview, but once it is loaded, it's very smooth and there are no problems at all. I built out another slide, adding multiple high-quality images, and I wanted to add a little bit of interactivity. Notice again how slow this triggers panel is to respond, both opening the trigger panel and then actually changing the options within that trigger panel. So working with the images and moving them around was great, but as soon as it came time to add that interactivity with the trigger panel, that's where problems came up. But you can see I built out this slide, and when you preview it, it looks just fine. After that, I added a 40-second high-quality video from Articulate's content library, and this was a great experience. It got added to the slide relatively quickly, and later when I went ahead and published the project, it seemed to go relatively quickly too. So when it comes to working with media, the Mac with the M1 chip does a great job, even within Storyline. Next, I cropped and trimmed the video just to see how Storyline would handle that. And it took about 40 seconds to fully render this about 40-second video. From there, I published these four slides just to see how long it would take, and it took about 30 seconds to publish these four slides with this video included. At this point, I really wanted to push Storyline to its limits, so I started duplicating slides, adding more objects, just to see how the responsiveness would be affected as more slides were added, and I kept seeing that it was honestly doing just fine, so I kept adding more and more and more until we wound up with over 100 slides. And at this point, I checked out the memory to see how we were doing. I tried moving things around and adding new things, and it really didn't seem like the performance was getting affected very much as I added more slides and made the file bigger. At this point, I have over 200 slides in the Storyline file, and you can see that creating a new trigger now is just as fast, if not feeling a little bit faster than when we were creating one with only a few slides in the file. So once I was done with that testing, I wanted to see how long it would take to save this big of a file, and it only took about 30 seconds to save it to my computer. Before wrapping up the testing, I really wanted to see if there was anything else that could be done about this trigger situation. Because as you can see, if it takes this long to create a new trigger every time you need one, this may not have been a very viable option for people who need to do development-intensive storyline tasks. But instead of using the trigger wizard window that pops up and trying to edit it that way, I went ahead and tried just modifying the triggers in the trigger panel on the right by selecting the hyperlinked part of the trigger and then changing it that way. And this had zero lag at all. So to create a new trigger, I would just copy and paste it on the object I needed it on. And then I can modify those options very easily without actually opening the trigger wizard. So if you're going to use Storyline on a Mac with an M1 chip, this is the way to work with triggers. Just use that panel on the right instead of trying to open up the trigger wizard. So as you can see, Articulate Storyline on a Mac with an M1 chip really isn't so bad. It can get a little bit laggy at times, but I have a feeling that if you work in this every day and find those workarounds, and if you devote even more system resources to it than I did in this video, then the experience on an M1 chip will be equivalent to using Storyline on any other Mac device. So if this video did help you, please go ahead and like it and drop a comment letting me know. If you're going to get this setup running for yourself or you're considering buying a MacBook, please check the description because I have links to all of the software and hardware that we discussed here, and using any of my affiliate links will really help out the channel. And last but not least, if you're an instructional designer or e-learning developer and this brought you some value, please consider subscribing because there is a lot more content like this coming your way.